good morning, and welcome to sunny Phoenix. I am so very honored to have been asked to present this year's Industry Achievement Award to our one and only Henry Ross. You see, not only is Henry one of the greatest leaders in ATSA's history, he is also my dear friend and one who has helped make the industry the best it can be. Henry is currently the Director of Government Relations for PlasticAid, where he has made his new industry home for several years now. Formerly, Henry was the Director of Sales and Marketing for Eastern Metal USA Sign, and his distinguished career in our industry goes back more than 35 years, where he served in industry-leading member companies such as Avery, Reflexite, Brightline, and WLI Industries. These prestigious ATSA members supported Henry's volunteerism and his efforts for decades. And I'm sure if asked, Henry would suggest that they all share in his limelight today. Unique when compared to other leaders in our industry is the fact that Henry has served both the M&S division of ATSA and the contractor side. This has given Henry the ability to address the interests of both sides exceptionally well, something that has served us all during all of Henry's years on the board of directors, and there have been many. Henry served as the longest standing president of the foundation's history. Following in his footsteps, he taught me a great deal, and I remember countless days of long hours sitting in his WLI office working on the foundation's strategic plan development. His passion for the organization resonated throughout that planning process, and it continues to serve us well today. Henry served in the highest position within our organization, that of chair. His expertise in government relations gave him a decided advantage while he led our organization through the fight for higher funding levels and core safety programs on Capitol Hill. His insight into the political process was monumental when developing our policy for the Highway Trust Fund legislation, and I often sat in awe of his perspective and his aptitude. Henry has also served for countless years on ATSA's TTC committee and on the National Committee. Through these roles, Henry pioneered the charge of complying with the new crashworthiness initiatives decades ago and was instrumental in allowing the industry to work with Federal Highway in making our roads safer while still enabling contractors to make efficient use of their rental fleets. Where many would have retired from these stringent roles, Henry continues making contributions today. And in the end, when many past chairs step out after their years of service, Henry continues to make himself available to our industry. He continues to participate on the board as a past chair and on the past chair's advisory board, always willing to lead tasks and charges. There are many, many attributes that make one worthy of this prestigious award. I hope I've demonstrated some of the most impressive in Henry's repertoire. But one that I haven't mentioned is one that allows Henry to build a strong and honorable network so that leading an industry seems almost like a walk in the park. And that attribute is Henry's relentless sense of humor and his wit. Sometimes, when times get tough and we all need a breather, Henry delivers in a big way. I'll never forget his stories, his jokes, and his sense of timing. More times than I can remember, Henry has brought a hearty laugh to us all. And so, without further ado, and with heartfelt congratulations, please join me in thanking Mr. Henry Ross.
Thank you. Thank you, Kathy, for your kind and generous introduction. You are a true friend. With my relationship with Kathy, I know that she won't take offense if I observe how rare it is to have such nice things said about somebody while they're still vertical. I want to acknowledge the other members nominated this year for this award, Dan Babcock and John Durkos. They're both very worthy nominees, and we appreciate their service to ATSA and to this industry, and I think we need to acknowledge them. I'd also like to thank my family, especially my wife Betty, for supporting my career, my frequent absences from home, and my participation in ATSA and other industry activities. I don't think anyone starts their career in our industry with the goal of receiving the prestigious Industry Achievement Award 40 years later. I certainly didn't. But this event has allowed me to be a little bit reflective about my career in this association, which has been such a big part of my working life. I attended my first ATSA meeting in Chicago in the fall of 1983. This was the meeting where the Sign Manufacturers Division was created. Prior to this, the only full members were traffic control companies. Since 1983, I have witnessed ATSA's growth as a trade association, adding members and divisions, adding committees and chapters, and moving into the big tent of Washington government relations with a message that safer roads save lives. Over the years, ATSA has been able to leverage its financial resources derived from its meetings, its training programs, and its members' dues, and has been able to combine these resources with a top-notch professional staff and an engaged volunteer membership to create an influential information source and loud voice on Capitol Hill promoting infrastructure safety that has saved lives, decreased injuries, reduced property damage, and contributed to an even more mobile society. We have a lot to be proud of, but like any worthy endeavor, the effort cannot stop. Those who follow us will deal with many of the same issues and will also be challenged by new ones that were never imagined 30 years ago. ATSA and groups like it will continue to depend on professional and volunteer talent as well as financial resources in order to face the transportation safety needs for the next few decades. In order for ATSA to continue to do good work that saves lives, it will need individuals to step forward to do this work, and for the companies that they work for to continue to support their participation and effort. As Kathy mentioned, I was very fortunate to work for companies that were committed financially to ATSA's success and who are willing to allow me to use a portion of my time to contribute to ATSA activities. I want to thank ReflexSight, now ORF All Americas, Brightline, WLI Industries, USA Sign, and especially PlasticAid for supporting my activities within ATSA. I encourage all ATSA member companies to continue to do your part in supporting this life-saving and life-changing work. Being recognized with this award is the highest honor that I can imagine, and I thank you very much.
Coming up.